out right now still. You see me, I say? And I go diving out right now. You see, right now we are going to link up with the Virgin in California, Zena.
Riding to the beach on my bicycle, riding past the homeless and the poor people.
I can't escape the feeling that's captured. Society, mindset,
functional. So like every time I turn on my radio, the sound that's coming out is only so. And they want to tell me that band is incredible, but when I play the reggae music, I'm too critical right now.
Red, red, gold and green. I'm long radio live.
Yeah, man, sounds of wisdom and sound.
Riding to the beach on my bicycle.
Truck title critical.
People, I can't escape from living in
the. I tell you, I said the thing real critical tonight, you know.
Dysfunctional. Seems like every time I turn on my radio, the sound that's coming out is only
all right.
And they want to tell me that band is incredible, but when I play the reggae music, I'm too critical right now. Critical right now. Just too critical for me.
Mindset. Mindset.
Right now. Them just too critical. People say they're hungry, there's no food to eat, when the only thing we're giving is the toxic meat. Politicians get upset when the masses speak, and the paycheck that we're getting is incomplete. Federal governments are using mind control, and we'll lock you in a prison without parole. They don't wanna see us gather like a Jericho, but it's time for them to crumble, cause they're critical right now. Right now, them just too critical for me. Critical, right now, them just too critical. We work so hard, we get to belly full, then contaminate the crops with a chemical. When I look at the sky, I see a chemtrail. We're told it's for our good if the sun fails. If we could not destroy the earth, it'd be a miracle. What they're calling patriotic is criminal. Fake news now spreads like an aerosol, but we have to seek the truth, cause we're critical right now. Turn on my radio, the sound that's coming out is only so. And they wanna tell me that band is incredible, but when I play the reggae music, I'm too critical right now. Critical right now, I'm just too critical for me. Critical right now, them just too critical. People say they're hungry, there's no food to eat, when the only thing we're giving is the toxic meat. Politicians get upset when the masses speak, and the paycheck that we're getting is incomplete. Federal governments are using mind control, and we'll lock you in a prison without parole. They don't wanna see us gather like a Jericho, but it's time for them to crumble, cause they're critical right now. Right now, them just too critical for me. Critical, right now, them just too critical. We work so hard, we get to belly full, then contaminate.
crops with a chemical. When I look at the sky, I see a chemtrail. We're told it's for our good if the sun fails. If we could not destroy the earth, it'd be a miracle. What they're calling patriotic is criminal. Fake news now spreads like an aerosol. But we have to seek the truth as the critical right now.
Tell you the thing well critical, you know.
For me, critical right now.
Yeah, man, voice of wisdom and sound.
Critical right now.
Track taking from his latest EP, his first EP, Zane, first EP for Grace, the ear wave, Zane. And without no further delay, I want to introduce the Virgin straight out of California to the item. Blessed love.
Greetings. I just stars give thanks for the vibes, man.
Wisdom and sound. Warm welcome, man.
Give thanks, brethren. No, I appreciate it, man. I know you've been putting a lot of great artists up, and just to be part of the show is a blessing, so I really am grateful.
Rastafari. Yeah, man, it's a great honor for you have the hype and the program. Yes, sir.
Give thanks.
Wow. Very powerful song from the eye. Critical, you know what I mean? Yeah. All right. Yeah, powerful song from the eye. Critical. Talk to you about it.
Yeah, true. So, no, I'll give thanks for that because it's just, it seems like it's always just in critical times, right? There's always something that you're dealing with. I mean, it was funny because I wrote that first verse probably, I don't know, 10 years ago, but I finished it up last year, and it all kind of went together. It all made sense, and we're dealing with so many just critical times. I mean, especially on the internet and the Facebook and the social media outlets. I mean, everybody has something to say. Everybody has an opinion, right? So it's just it boggles my mind a little bit, and I get caught up in all of this stuff going on a bit because, well, first of all, I want to be educated and know what's going on in my community and, of course, the world community. But once you start to dive deep, it just starts to kind of boggle you down. And it's like, man, you know, just trying to find that solution. And the reason why I just finished this recently is because I finally like found that solution, which is the music, you know?
Yes, I.
So, yeah, man, give thanks for that.
Yes, I.
But, one of the, go ahead,
Rich. Yes, critical, Zane. Very critical time, as they say. The eye is from the US, California, right? Mm-hmm.
Yep. Currently, I'm actually currently in Florida, so I stay both coasts.
Yes, I. Freedom of movement.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah, give thanks for that, you know.
Yes. All right. We see right now, you know, because it's critical. We see in America that, you know, even your president right now has shut down the government, you know, and that has, you know, become a critical, very critical thing right now, you know, in the history of America. What do I view pan the whole of that?
Oh, man. Give thanks. I can get into a story about it. But, you know, what it comes down to, and again, I don't know how deep you guys dig over on the UK side. I would assume a lot. But basically, we're dealing with this whole border wall thing, right? And this migrant caravan of people who are basically seeking asylum, right? They've been dealing with problems in their own country, and so now they're coming and they want to have obviously what they consider is the American dream. And so now that's, you know, that could be, we could talk about that in a whole another story, but basically what it comes down to is, you know, it's essentially manufactured, you know what I mean? There's always people that want to come over into the borders. And I think it's the same for any country, you know, it's like whether we go to Mexico or Mexico comes here, or we're going to Canada, Canada comes here, or I'm sure, you know, I've never actually been to Europe, but I know how it kind of works. And you can travel to Spain and Amsterdam or Netherlands, so on and so forth, back to the UK freely and easily. And that's pretty much what it comes down to. And to create sort of this separation, right, between these people and the makeup. Oh, now we have all these terrorists and so forth that want to come over and start to infiltrate America. So now they want to put up a border wall. And basically what it comes down to is Donald Trump seemingly, you know, I take everything with a grain of salt, but seemingly closes down the government because he wants a five.
Yeah, tell her, see it there. Thing well critical, you know. I don't know how the call us cut out like that. But what they said we could drop the song. We could drop the song again, Carl.
Riding to the beach on my bicycle, riding past the homeless and the poor people. I can't escape from living in this capital society that's dying and dysfunctional. So like every time I turn on my radio, the sound that's coming out is only so. And they wanna tell me that band is incredible, but when I play the reggae music, it's too critical.
I don't know, I'm gonna try if I connect up again.
Mindset bigger. Boom. Riding through.
And see if we can get the virgin back on the lines, eh?
Homeless and the poor people. I can't escape from living in this capital society that's dying.
Sounds of wisdom and sound.
Like every time I turn on my radio.
Well, critical, you know.
Coming out is only soul.
First track, you know.
You wanna tell me that band is incredible, but when I play the reggae music, I'm too critical right now.
Man said I'm too critical, yeah. Just a bill of water, they shut down the whole thing.
Critical right now, them just too critical for me. Critical right now, them just too critical. People say them hungry, there's no food to eat, when the only thing we're giving is some toxic meat. Politicians get upset when the masses speak, and the paycheck that we're getting is incomplete. Federal governments are using mind control, and we'll lock you in a prison without parole. And I wanna see us gather like a Jericho, but minds that make them crumble cause I'm critical right now. Right now, them just too critical for me. Critical right now.
Blessed love.
Yes, I.
Yes, I. One welcome again, man. Yes.
Yeah, give thanks. My deepest apologies. I don't know what happened.
Yes, I saw them thing that go, man. I don't know. Yes, I.
Right on.
Yeah, it look away. It look away still, you know, just to build a wall to keep out, keep out mm-hmm. people, you know.
Exactly, and you know what it's really doing is it's costing a lot more money than what he's asking for, you know, and what it's doing essentially is to the people in this country who can't afford health care, who can't afford medicine, you know, to even feed their children a decent meal. And that's what it's really hurting at the end of the day. And of course, I know it's kind of like this all over the world, it seems, but it's that these guys who are multi-million dollar people, billionaires even, they are, you know, receiving all these tax breaks and receiving all this extra income that it does not trickle down. You know, it's there, that's never worked. And so it's just squeezing the regular, you know, 9-to-5 everyday person.
Yeah.
You know, it's just squeezing. So
yeah, because you know, when you look upon it realistically, who would pay for it, you know?
Because right, exactly.
Yeah, you know, that would come from the taxpayers' money, and then probably the taxpayers, you know, they would have to work more hours.
Mm-hmm. Know what I mean? Absolutely. And they said like some odd 800,000 federal workers went without pay. I mean, that's incredible. And so I read reports of certain national parks are being, you know, vandalized and things like that just because there's no rangers or nobody to watch these things. So it's like, you know, when this kind of thing happens, it's the things that aren't so important to the government are destroyed and ruined first, you know?
Yes, I. Yes, I. So, yeah, man, them people, you know, probably in a different league of their own, you know?
Yeah, indeed, man. And yeah, it's just something else because, you know, that's, again, I revert to the music and it's like, that's like my outlet to just do what I love and to feel that vibe, you know, when you could think about all the negativity and just kind of like, you know, all the oppressors, if you will. I mean, it's just constant. It really is constant. And even in our world, just on a domestic level, if you will, you know, what are people around you eating, right? And it's like, man, they're eating some chemical-ridden foods, right? Some like nasty stuff. And that thing's acceptable amongst everybody, you know, everybody. So just to stay focus or not to focus on such the negative aspects, it's like that's why I choose the music, and that's why, you know, I've sort of sacrificed that lifestyle of you know, working and trying to get a lot of money to just get a lot of music.
All right. Yes sir. All right,
you know,
first EP, right?
Mm-hmm.
Talk to me about you know, approaching the music, getting involved in the music.
When all did right. that start? Yeah, out? Well, basically, so it. I mean, for music in general, it just goes back to like being involved with, you know, school band, learning music, and then listening to a lot of music. But when you talk specifically about reggae music, you know, that's a whole nother story because that sort of it's phenomena, if you will, that's been instilled, you know, in me and like the heart and soul. And this kind of goes back to the question of the approach, because I don't just approach it as music, but I approach it as reggae music, Rastafari music. You know, when I think of Rastafari, just because I'm a realist and understand my place and my roots and my culture, right? And so I see Rastafari, of course, Haile Selassie. I respect the man immensely and the representation of the Holy Trinity, obviously. But when it goes back to that one spiritual thing, what is that, right? The Almighty, Jah, the Almighty God. And so that's the approach, right? That's the motivation. And so, you know, and it's more on like a human level, not necessarily biblical, although I do study the Bible constantly, but it's more like in simplistic ways, you know, simplistic terms that anybody can understand. And again, without, you know, for me, as far as approaching that, you know, the reggae music specifically, is like, I don't want to fake it. You know, I never wanted to fake like a Jamaican accent or fake my terminology or this or that. You know, just come real with it. And that's something that,
yeah,
you know, and again, like, I know who I am in my place, in my roots and culture, right? So but you know, my whole thing is, and I love other cultures, right? Like, I study martial arts, Chinese martial arts. And so I love the Chinese culture, you know, I love Asian culture. I love, of course, Jamaican culture, Rastafari culture. And it's, for me, I would never look, and hopefully I could be consistent with my words, you know, and actions, but I would never look to sort of use those things or exploit those things. I always want to basically embrace those and enhance those things and share those things, because they've been shared with me, and I get so much gratification from those different cultures and, you know, different flavors, different sounds, different sights and whatnot, right?
Yeah.
So that for me is like, you know, to know and like give respect is huge in the first place, you know. And so to go back to the roots and, you know, being, I did grow up in Florida, and I got to, you know, fortunately for me, I was on a bunch of cruises with my aunt and grandma when I was a real young kid, like 8 years old. And so, and we went to all the islands, and it did something to me that was just, you know, the spirit, right? The spirit just came through, and I recognized that as a young child. And then, of course, growing up, my dad had a bunch of records, vinyl records, ton of Bob Marley, of course, Black Uhuru, Peter Tosh, I mean, you name it, he pretty much had all the classics. And so just kind of getting that spirit first and foremost, because that I learned, you know, or received that blessing when I was in my youth, before I ever picked up a musical instrument, you know. And so once I started learning instruments and all the good stuff, that's when I fused those two things together. And so to me, you know, reggae is so much more powerful than just music.
So you were saying your father would play them artists that regular in the house.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, tons, because my dad, you know, he was like a hippie, right? So he had a ton of vinyl. And I mean, you know, not just reggae, he had a bunch of classic rock and blues and all that stuff. But it was the reggae that really grabbed me. And I can't tell you specifically why, you know, I mean, I have those experiences, I've been around the culture, but I can't necessarily tell you why that happened. It just did, you know? And so with my dad having those things, it totally enhanced that love for reggae. And I swear there was a point in time where I would not listen to any other music except reggae music. So.
All right. We are Premier Day. We are Premier Day EP today, Zeal. So, mm-hmm. You know, I'm going to play another song from the EP, and this one is titled Reggae Strong As Ever, right?
Give thanks. Yes, I.
From his brand new EP.
And I praise Rastafari ever after pretend, because reggae strong as ever, and you know won't end. This the type of music that I have to hear.
Me I tell ya, mindsets. Mm-hmm.
Reddit, red, gold and green. I'm long radio live.
love, and you can't get enough. The people come around. Give thanks, I not pull any pranks. I know gratitude is rare, but what I ask from the start. Red, gold, and green is what I happy display to remember the king who taught the righteous way. Not make any sense if you make an offense. Selassie teach acceptance if you hear what I'm saying.
Brand new from Wisdom and Sauna.
Praise Rastafari, never have to pretend, because reggae strong as ever, and you know won't end.
Straight out of California,
that I have to defend. And if you
we have the Virgin live on the program, you know,
the devil not like it, me comfy mad.
Featuring his brand new EP,
a chance to come in here.
Taiko Wisdom and Sound.
Stop, the lyrics not fluff, and you can't get.
Consists of 5 tracks. We'll play 2 of them so far now.
Rastafari culture is a blessing from God. It was given to men, all women and child. Please have some respect, I know this is correct. Whoever can appreciate is who I applaud.
It's a safe vibration. Yeah, I tell you. Mindsets, mindsets.
Watch here, watch here, watch here. You know what I say? When you go and go check out the EP, you know, which wherever the EP there, when you go and go check out the EP. Blessed love, my general.
Yes, I just start. Good thanks.
Yes, I. Powerful song, amen. You know. Powerful song.
Give thanks, bro.
Where the inspiration come from?
That one, man. So, I think, again, man, and it's kind of goes back to sort of the first question too, but
yeah,
it's like forever I've been an audio engineer, and since 2004 when I first moved to Cali from Florida, and I went out there, worked with some artists. I had a quick phone call conversation with Scientist, the engineer, I'm sure you know who he is, and he said, go and cite this band down in San Diego, Cushion of Blood, Fire, Angels. And since that, I just kind of put in everything into being an engineer and producing everybody. And so it was like I was looking and searching for myself, you know, for sort of who I am as an artist. And, you know, I played other instruments, played drums for a lot of bands and backed other artists. But I always wanted to be the artist, you know? And so it took a lot of growth and a lot of sort of finding myself in some transitions to figure out sort of who I was, you know what I mean? And so I had some run-ins with some Rasta brethren that questioned me at the time. And just, you know, at the time I grew my dreadlocks out and took the vow of Nazarite to heart. And I, you know, took that for 12 years. And then a couple of Rasta brethren sort of questioned me, and, you know, these were very African rooted brethren. And so I valued what he thought, you know, I valued his opinion. And so it sort of made me kind of figure out like what I was and who I was. And so after kind of long story short, right, after kind of struggling with that and just going through more growth and years of growth and different processes, I come to sort of determine, you know, who I was and like found my voice finally. And that was actually last March 2018, which I discovered that I want to go full on with my artistry, just being inspired by other artists, namely Protégé. When I saw him last year, like February, I was like blown away. But basically, I just kind of figured like, where do I stand on this, and how am I going to grapple or express where I am with Rastafari and culture, right? Without, and you know, you're going to be judged no matter what. And it is what it is, but at least I want to put it out there and let people know what it is to me. And so that's what this song really came from. You know, what is Rastafari? What is reggae culture to me? And what does that feel like? And I wanted to express that, you know, through this song and kind of give others an insight. Maybe that'll help others kind of decide what it is for them, you know, what Rastafari means to them. And so that was kind of it, man. Just my statement of Rastafari, my love for Rastafari, for reggae culture, for reggae and Rastafari people, and just that spirit again, because to me, it's just so powerful. And it's, you know, what did they say? There's like a saying, you know, you could run from God, but God will never run from you. And it's just like that, you know, it's just like that. Not that I've ever tried to leave, you know, the Almighty or anything like that in those terms, but it was like, you know, who am I again? Am I part of Rastafari? And can I be part of that culture? And I've come to know it as that spirit, right? It all goes back to the spirit. And so that's what I wanted, you know, that's what I wanted to convey in that tune. And hopefully I did it.
Yes, I powerful, powerful, you know, powerful, powerful.
Give thanks.
All right, we're gonna feature another song, you know what I mean?
All right.
Yeah, we're gonna feature another song. Track title, Cool Out.
True.
Live Radio, the Mindset Program. I just star, I'm your host, and we're live with Wisdom and Sound. Blessed love and be my general.
Greetings, I just stars.
Yes, I cool out, yeah. Cool out. Another track from the EP. Yes, I.
Yeah.
When I listen to your music, it come across like, you know, it is like politically motivated in a sense.
Mm.
You think that's fair?
Absolutely, absolutely. You know, I was thinking about that too, because, you know, 3 out of the 5 tracks are very politically motivated, and you know, I don't necessarily want to turn people off because it's, you know, a lot of reggae. There's a lot of very happy reggae. But when I think of music, you know, for me, from what I'm doing is it's got to be about consciousness, right? Consciousness. And so what is it that we're talking about here? And you know, to me, I see, you know, we live in Babylon. Simple enough. We live in Babylon. So what is there not to talk about? You know what I'm saying? And so I want to put those issues set forth. Like, those should always be at the forefront, you know, about conscious living. In an individual aspect is, you know, just being self-aware, you know, what the individual is doing on a daily basis and what your energy is creating, right? Because we all can, every single day, I feel like we're all artists, right? And so, like, I take sort of the martial arts training, and it's like, you know, you can do kung fu in every single thing you do, whether the way you wipe, you know, your dresser down, or the way that you hang up your coat, or the way that you treat people. You know, these things are all combined and all together. And so it's about being aware of what it is that you're doing, and everything has an effect. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
At the state, you know what I mean? So at the state of the world that we're in today, I mean, there's many beautiful things to enjoy and to embrace on this planet still, thank goodness, you know, but at the same time, there's so many unnecessary energies that we're using and wasting, and the result of that energy, what we're creating because of that use of energy is destructive. You know, it's destructive to the earth, to humans, to animals. I mean, it's just, and it seems on a mass scale, think about, like, in America alone, to feed the country, you have the kind of farming that we have, you know, with mass slaughtering of animals. This is very detrimental, you know, very detrimental. But that overtakes, like, let's even talk about people that are vegan or plant-based. I mean, meat eaters overtake that. And so the result of getting a piece of meat, for instance, just an example, that overtakes the fact, you know, the percentage-wise, if you look at this compared to that. So we should be focusing on these things because they're very prominent, and it's wrong at the end of the day. You know, I mean, I know there's very distinct opinions about right and wrong, but when you're destroying the planet, I think it's just wrong. You know, I feel like there's alternative ways to do it where you don't have to cause the same destruction. So those are the kinds of things I want to bring out. You know, I want to bring out that just making people aware and conscious, you know, not in a negative way, but at least, you know, show them like the light. You know, that's how I feel about it. It's not bringing out darkness. It's just showing them the light. Because look, let's not even focus on, again, just as the meat example, let's not focus on that industry, but let's just look at the benefits of being plant-based. You know, just that alone is a beautiful thing. So we should probably subscribe to that, because not only are you going to be healthy, but you're also going to contribute to the earth and your fellow humans in a good way.
True. You know? True.
Yeah.
Yes, I. Yeah, man. Real talk.
Always. So.
You know, reggae music, very powerful music, and through the creation, you know, the ones them who create the music, you know, these Rasta Virgin, these early Rasta Virgin and thing. And, you know, as Rasta, one of the things that Rasta really agitate for is, you know, is for freedom and redemption, international repatriation. You know, Four Wings for, you know, black African people within the diaspora that has been taken illegally from the African continent to the Western hemisphere and have been treated in the most horrific way. Zin and Rasta has over the years have chanted, you know, to return home, Zin. by the colonial government that have taken black people to here. All right. My question to the eye, Zane. The eye see that your ancestors, Zane, are who is in power today. Zane, do you see that they should pay black people, African people, to repatriate home? As you know, they speak about Selassie and Rastafari and the music and thing. Do you see that the item of a pay African people to repatriate home? You think that is a fair thing?
Absolutely. I mean, without a doubt, I feel that, again, you know, the atrocities that have been just caused to the African nation in general speaking, I mean, it's incredible, right? It's incredible. It's everything that you would think of when you think of inhumane. And so, you know, I feel this has been a question or just an awareness that has been constantly being raised. And it has to be, yeah, you know, because it's completely discredited. You know, it's always completely discredited when somebody who again, it's the oppressed being oppressed, you know, the oppressors oppressing. And so when you have, you know, any kind of movement, especially when it comes down to the you know, minorities, specifically black people, it's just always going to be twisted by the media, always. And so the media, unfortunately, has their hand in every pot, and they can control people's minds, and it's just sad, you know. But then, you know, and it goes back again, because we're talking about paying for Africans to repatriate, which they're trying to raise $5 trillion for this wall to separate people. Yeah. When, you know, that money could, I mean, easily could be reprocessed and given out and awarded and retributed. You know what I mean? It's like, I feel that would be just a wonderful, beautiful thing for this planet. Absolutely.
Selassie, I know.
Yes, isn't Ethiopia, wasn't it, and it's still uncolonized to this day?
True.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, so, very correct,
my brother. Yeah, yeah, that, shouldn't that be how it is, you know? Shouldn't that be the standard of living, you know, where people have solidarity?
Well, that is a serious thing, you know. That is, you see, that point that we are raising now, that is a serious point, because... All right.
True.
When you look at it, then Zane, when you look at it, then you know your ancestors, my ancestors, that's there in the West, Zane, would be seen now as immigrant. You know what I mean? So would have to return to wherever we're from. All right, I'm from Africa. All right, naturally there is from Europe, so there I would probably come back into some place in Europe, probably England or Germany or Scotland or wherever in you know what I mean? Because that's what it would boil down to.
Yep. That's interesting. You know, that's interesting, because when you talk and when you talk about just being able, back to something I said earlier, being able to absorb and experience other cultures, I think there is so many good things in that too, right? But obviously it becomes a problem when those cultures get exploited and those people of those cultures are exploited. That's where we have a problem, you know?
Yes. But
I feel like, you know, and then when you're, you know, for instance, and, you know, we can use many examples, but in this country specifically with the Native Americans, you know, nowadays, I mean, well, the Native Americans, they're completely outnumbered, but at the same time, what's happening is their customs, cultures are being wiped out. And so now you're having the American culture you know, originally European culture coming over and telling them, no, you need to eat this and you need to take this medicine and you need to do, and you, when it's always imposed. And that should never be, that should never happen, right? It should be, I respect you and you respect me. And it's a mutual understanding. You have your customs and cultures and I have my customs and cultures. And true. I know I'm kind of talking in utopia ways, but I mean, gosh, it just seems so simple to me.
But it's the reality. It's the reality. Yes. The
reality. Yeah.
All right. We'll have a play another song from the IEP, Zina. This one titled Had Enough, Zina. I think we have enough. This one is brand new, all right?
Yo, Wisdom and Sound. I'm here to tell you, don't be constrained by society. Don't allow yourself to be held down by the red and blue politicians, the critics. Because while they're all complaining, we're here pursuing a dream. Can you ease it up? Jah release the pressure. I wanna tear it up.
Me, I tell ya, mindset.
Ready, for that. Red, gold, and green. I'm long radio live.
Yo, Wisdom and Sound. I'm here to tell you. Don't be constrained by society. Don't allow yourself to be held down by the red and blue politicians, the critics. Because while they're all complaining, we're here pursuing a dream. Can you ease it up? Only Jah release the pressure. I wanna tear it up. Break us down, no one can do. So can you turn it? Wisdom and Sound. I draw stars, yeah, for tell them. Don't be constrained by society. Don't be held down by the red blue politicians.
Ready, red, gold, and green. I'm locked radio live.
Can you ease it up? Only Jah release the pressure. I wanna tear it up. Break us down, no one can do. So can you turn it up? They can't silence us forever. Have you had enough? Stand firm in a world of uproar. What is honor when your words are causing war? Intolerance is rough. Who hasn't had enough? It doesn't take a thing to be enlightened. A better world where there's peace, not fighting. You know the feeling when they seem corrupt. You have to be abrupt, no time to get mixed up. So can you ease it up? I just stars release the pressure. I wanna tear it up.
Sounds of Wisdom and Sound.
So can you turn it up?
Taken from his brand new EP.
Silence us forever.
Track title, Had Enough.
Life of mistrust, forced to fire by the rules imposed on us. Shouldn't act surprised, you craft your own demise. Respect due to the ones authentic, pure of heart what we're representing. When the system going up in flame, you have to move with aim. Victory can claim, so can you ease it up? Only Jah release the pressure.
Yeah man, brand new, may I tell a brand new. Brand new, it's very brand new. It's very, you know what I mean? Yes. Yes, Wisdom and Sound, may I tell you, we love them energy and vibration there. No? Had Enough.
Yeah, man. Give thanks, brethren.
Yes, sir. Powerful. And is the eye playing all the instrument on this production, right?
Yes, everything, but except for the guitars, which I had. I was blessed to have this brethren, Blaine Dillinger. He plays in a band called Hyrie out here. He played some guitars on it for me, which was really, really nice.
Yes, I the guitar, yeah man. The production, lovely production.
Yeah, give thanks, man. You know, I've been, you know, to be honest, I make that all on the computer. It's all on the computer, and so my whole goal, you know, I've been trained as a professionally engineer, so I can kind of work with my tools or whatever, but that's the whole thing, is like, make this stuff in the computer sound real, you know, sound authentic as possible. So
yes, I. And what the people can find the EP, or them can get the EP?
Yes, so the EP will be out tomorrow, and it's going to be on all channels: iTunes, Google Play, Spotify. I have videos up on YouTube, some lyric videos, Amazon, wherever you can get music, it's all there. And then, of course, my website, wisdomandsound.com. I'm all over the social medias, at Wisdom and Sound, all spelled out. So, yeah, you'll be able to find it, no problem.
Yes, I. And we hope to see the eye, you know, touring this you know, doing some tour and thing.
Mm-hmm, definitely. I'm actually have rehearsal tonight with a band I've been putting together, and it's, you know, it's a process. Everything's a process. So I just, you know, until I can find the right people or whatnot, I'm just going to keep making music and putting out singles. And you know, there's no one else doing it with me, so I'm doing the marketing, the photography, everything. So, and it's all good. I give thanks, but you know, just one thing at a time. But as soon as I can get this band rocking, which we're making progress, it's sounding good, and definitely want to start hitting the local venues, and then take it much further. Of course, the West Coast, we want to definitely do that, and then I would love to come over your way and bless the people and definitely feel the blessings, you know.
Yes sir. And what would be the biggest show for the eye performing on?
Yeah, Kim, thanks for asking that. That's funny, because part of the dream is to play Rototom Sunsplash in Spain. I mean, it's just huge. Everyone's heard of it, of course. Summer Jam, I think that one's in Germany, if I'm correct. You probably know better than I. But yeah, definitely Rototom would be a huge moment in my life. And so, yeah, that's what I'm working for, you know?
Rastafari. So you never hear about Rebel Salute and them shows there?
Yeah, I definitely saw Rebel Salute, what happened. It's interesting, very interesting, you know? But that, you know, it's not uncommon.
Some fest and them other events there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, all right. It's been a great honor, my general, because we kind of run out of time. Zane, we have about 1 minute left on the program and thing. But it's been a great honor, you know what I mean, having the eye on the program and reasoning with the eye, you know what I mean. And
yes,
the music is great, you know what I mean. Continue doing what you're doing, and you know, saying what you're saying, it's making a lot of sense. And you know what I mean, just keep it, you know, keep it on a level, and you know, we know we see the eye across, you know, across the networks, you know.
Yes, I give thanks, I Draw Stars, because you know, you've definitely been an inspiration, what you're doing over there, and then just giving the love and support is huge, and I am totally grateful, you know. So it's a blessing for sure.
Yes, my brother, it's a great honor, man. It's a great honor. You know, we're just
likewise.
What we there for, do you know? Yes,
yes, I.
Yes, I. Yeah, man. More love, more strength, and you know, more strength on the EP. You know, we hope it you know, do very well.
Yeah, man. Give thanks. Much respect and love always.
Ah. Yes, I. More love and strength, my general.
Cool. Amen. Give
let Jah be praised. The goose and the ghost, let Jah be praised. The Daniel Lamb, let Jah be praised. Let him be praised.
let him be praised. You better let him.